Welcome to our social studies lesson. Our topic, resources and economic activities, and subtopic trade. So we start by asking ourselves, what is trade? Trade is an activity of buying and selling of goods and services between people or countries. So the buying and selling of goods and services between people or countries, this is what we are calling trade. This exchange of goods and services, that is what we are calling trade. So we have types of trade. Of course, there are two. One is internal trade or domestic trade, and the second one is external trade or international trade. So, when we talk about internal trade or domestic trade, this is the exchange of goods and services within a country. Within a country, that is what we are calling internal trade, and that's why it is called domestic, because it is within one country. Then, when we are talking about the external trade now involves the exchange of goods and services between our countries. Kenya may sell its goods to Tanzania or to other countries. And now that is why it's called an international, because now it is involving other countries or many countries. So we have now the benefits of trade. Why is trade important? One is that trade leads to creation of employment opportunities. Trade itself now, it creates employment opportunities. So some people work as traders, and that is now an employment opportunity. Second importance of the second benefit is that it helps in expanding agriculture and industrial activities. It helps in expanding agriculture and industrial activities, whereby now the goods that are produced in the industries, they are sold through trade. Also, some agricultural products are sold through trade. That is now how it expands these two sectors, agriculture and the industries. Then number three is that it promotes understanding and cooperation among the trading partners. It promotes understanding and cooperation now among the trading partners. So the country, let's say there's the countries that are involved in trading. So these countries cooperate so that the trade can move on well. Also the people now involved in trade, the traders themselves, they have to cooperate so that now their businesses can go on well. Then another importance is that it promotes growth of towns, the trade itself, the business activities. The trade activities makes now or promote the growth of towns. Most of the towns are developed in areas where now we have good trading activities. Then another importance is that government earns revenue. So most of the government itself now earns revenue through trading licenses, and also the tax that now these traders remit. Then promote exchange of information and ideas. Also trade now promote the exchange of information and ideas. So as these people now exchange their goods and services, also they exchange some ideas and also information. So we have also now the problems facing trade. Problems facing trade is one of the problems is the similarity of goods. So there is this production of similar goods, let's say that by people, or that is the traders, or even the countries themselves produce similar goods, and now they cannot, this will not promote trade since they will not be changing because they are similar goods. Then another one is the fluctuation of prices. The fluctuation of prices, this includes now there are sometimes when the prices are too high, other times the prices are too low. So this fluctuation now sometimes makes trade difficult. Then poor roads and other infrastructures. So as now the trade, we have said it is the exchange of goods and services. So this goods needs to move or needs to be transported from one place to another. So if we have poor roads, that's a problem. Also another problem is political differences. By now the leaders of countries, they might differ politically, and this now it does smooth running of businesses, that is trade. Then low prices, sometimes the goods that are produced, sometimes they are low prices, or the prices get too low, and now these are now affecting the traders. There's also political instabilities. Now let's say in some countries now whereby the government are not stable, the trade is not easy, the trading activities will not be easy. Then another one, we have trade barriers. So Some countries have some tariffs that now hinder traders from moving from one country to another or from one place to another so that they can take on their, or they can go on with their trading activities. Lastly, lack of common currency. So where now we are involving two countries or more, the lack of common currency makes it difficult. This is how you have to, if you are moving from Kenya, let's say, take it for example, if you want to move from Kenya to Tanzania, you have to change your money from the Kenyan shillings to Tanzanian shillings so that now you can buy whatever you want. So that is that for today. For more of this, you'll get them in our summer class app. Have a good day.